What's up, everybody? It's Thursday. I don't know the date. Well, I don't keep track of that. But I want to say it's day 17. Day 17 of daily uploads. God, that was the slowest intro. It's probably not. No one's gonna watch past that. Anyways, leg day today. Fucking sick. Fucking intense. I for sure leveled up some lifts. My leg press has to go heavier again. My leg extensions have to go heavier. My adductor has to go heavier. And I dropped the weight for my standing calf raise because I think I was going a little ego and didn't quite hit 20. And so I just need to drop it. But that's only by like 10 pounds and it'll benefit me more in the long run to do that. But it's going great. Everything's still moving smoothly. Pumps are insane. I mean, I'm seeing definition on my legs that I wasn't before and they're pumped. So I should be losing minuscule definition, but it's feeling itself out. Like, it's sick. I think it's the expanded glycogen stores and the intensity on the pumps. It's just going a long ways, man. Like, it's kind of crazy. Don't really, like, see it that often in training. But this training method, man, there's something to it. I've been saying it. I'll keep saying it. And the results will speak for themselves. While I'm speaking for them at the same time, of course, but that's just me trying to promote my knowledge and experience and understanding to help other people expand their own knowledge and apply things for themselves. Once I actually promote this training method, I'm never going to promote a program. I'm going to promote a formula to create your own program and to take my principles and my understanding and apply it for yourself. Because nothing is copy-paste with lifting. Nothing is copy-paste. But you're going to find why things work, where to apply them, and how to see the most results tailored to you. You're going to learn how to tailor your training to yourself, which is the most important part. Because everyone's training is going to be different to some degree. I mean, there's things that'll work across the board because they're for intended different purposes, but it's not just like, oh, hit bench press, you'll grow your chest. It's, you know, when you need, you know, you have your overload type of lift before your hypertrophy, you know, that would be like your bench before your flies. That type of structure is across the board, whereas exercise by exercise aren't necessarily across the board. But that, yeah, I'm yapping now. We're yapping like a little chihuahua. I want to eat cleaner if I can, because I feel like my body would just do so much better if I could eat fully clean. I mean, I don't eat a lot of fast food, but I eat a lot of processed food, you know, some Ritz crackers are easy carbs, easy on the stomach. I, you know, probably drink more juice than I should, because to be fair, it's easy carbs, easy calories, it tastes good. Little quick energy boost. I don't know, there's just a bunch of things I wish I could cut out and just eat fully clean, whole food. But it's not viable right now. It'd be too expensive as it is. Once I can get my income, you know, at a higher volume, I'll be able to do that. But even then, I don't think I'll try and perfect eat clean, eat whole food until I have the ability to maintain that and not have it draw from other sources or other expenditures that I actually need. Yeah, it is what it is. I don't know where to go from here. I mean, legs went great, posing went great, posing is getting better. Gonna be working the next 3 days through. It's Friday, Saturday, Sunday. I think I just have Saturday as a lift because that's rest, push, rest, pull shoulders. Maybe I'll see. It might work out Sunday too. If I can not have my hamstrings too sore to do it, because they're, you know, going super hard on seated leg curl. But if I could, you know, skip that rest day, then put a rest day in between shoulders and back, that would probably be better in terms of recovery and performance. But either way, we'll get the lift in, we'll get the recovery in, the rest in, the food in, and we'll get the muscle on. I'm excited to do the strength block though. I'm not ready for 2.5 months until then, but trust the process, be patient, and it will pay off. I'll put on so much more muscle that I'll be able to convert it to strength. And I should pretty quickly bench 275, should pretty quickly like move up in strength. And then once my muscles are readapted to strength and compounds and heavy lifting, then I go into the peaking process and just see what I can fucking hit, which that will be pretty cool, actually. I'm pretty excited for it. I might get a coach for that. I'm gonna look into it. Probably talk to PJ again, but we'll see. We'll see. Whatever ends up working out, just I don't have enough experience with powerlifting and peaking as it is. So I may look to exterior knowledge and help to teach and learn along the way while still applying my own principles and making sure it's in line with what I know. But the point is to do true powerlifting, you know, to learn the peaking from an expert. I mean, could even work not just to have it programmed for me and just work like together to program it together. We'll see, but it'll be a fun process, to say the least. And it'll be a learning experience at the same time. Be great to have in my tool belt, even if I have to do it differently in the future and it doesn't work like I hope. But looking like it's running long here, so gonna head home, gonna eat some food, gonna get some sleep, and then get up and bust ass for some hours tomorrow. I think it's gonna be 8 hours, but that's solid $200, bro. Can't complain. What's real will prosper. So be true to yourself. You'll find peace. Much love.